हेलो। या गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
You are watching Sailor Today TV, your unmissable dose of vitamin C. Hello, friends. Starting soon, an unmissable live coverage here on Sailor Today TV.
of Shipping are honored and delighted to host roadshow and MOU signing ceremony of the Maritime India Summit 2021. I now request Shri K.S. Bariyar, Additional Director General of Shipping, to give welcome address. Thank you.
Thank you, Vishen. Very good morning to you all. On behalf of the Director General of Shipping, all officers and staff of the Directorate, and on my own behalf, I welcome all our esteemed guests, stakeholders, and partners from all the sectors of the maritime industry, all associations, unions, seafarers, trainee seafarers, press and media personnel, present in this physical cum virtual roadshow and MOU signing event. A warm welcome to all of you. We value and treasure your partnership. Maritime India Summit 2021 has been organized by the Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways, and is a three-day event commencing 2nd March and will be inaugurated by our Honorable Prime Minister. The event brings various stakeholders in the maritime sector, including policymakers, planners, domestic and international investors, CEOs, industry experts, bankers and insurers, major ports and shipping lines from across the world on a common platform. The summit provides abundant opportunities for promoting domestic and international investment in the maritime sector. Its virtual platform also gives meeting facilities for networking, which is very important for any global trade. The roadshow will showcase the outcome of the efforts, planning, and multiple engagements the DG Shipping has made with the industry partners, associations, and unions during the last few months. Industry partners and associations have reaffirmed their commitment and assured investment and job opportunities valued over 20,000 crores and over 61 MOUs will be signed by these partners with DG Shipping at this event. We will be announcing the details of these MOUs as they are signed and executed. I will now call upon DG Shipping to kindly declare the roadshow and MOU signing event open.
I declare the Maritime India Summit 2021 DGS Roadshow and MOU signing event open.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Over to Vishen.
Now we will be screening a short film on Maritime India Summit 2021. May I request to start the movie?
The Indian ports, shipping and waterways industry plays a vital role in sustaining growth in the country's trade and commerce. India is the 16th largest maritime country in the world, with a coastline of about 7,517 kilometers. India has 12 major and 205 notified minor and intermediate ports, and around 95% of India's trading by volume and 70% by value is done through maritime transport. To explore the potential business opportunities in Indian maritime sector and to provide a powerful platform for international collaboration and bring in partner countries for mutual exchange of knowledge and opportunities, we welcome you to the second edition of Maritime India Summit 2021, which is being organized by Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways, Government of India, jointly with FICCI as industry partner and EY as knowledge partner. On the website www.maritimeindiasummit.in, one would find different options which would provide the insight to this mega event. Under Maritime India Summit 2021, you will find information about the organizers, the show and the event components. Click on Conference to find the conference agenda for all 3 days. After clicking on Exhibition, you will find a complete exhibitor profile for the ease of buyers and visitors. Click on Visitors tab to find the available visitor profiles segregated according to different categories, which will help the user to identify the field they are interested in during the summit. Under the registration dropdown, the exhibitors and visitors would find forms for registration and submission. The guidelines will guide both the exhibitor and visitor to complete their registration and to access the virtual convention center. To know more about the maritime sector, click on Sector Overview and Investment Opportunities. For any queries or concerns, please visit our FAQs page. You can also find all contact names and details for any further assistance. The Maritime India Summit 2021 will be virtually organized on Fiki Bike, which is a self-developed virtual portal for business, information, knowledge and education. Click on Info for general information. Exhibitors, delegates and visitors can use their login credentials to access. Exhibition area. At the information counter, you can reach out to our representative for any support. Real-time answers will be provided during the summit. Click on Info, and under the profile drop-down, you will find the detailed 3-day agenda with complete detailing of each session and program. You will also find the event brochure and the name and contact details of our team member for any assistance. Click on Pavilions to reach various pavilions. Click on one of the pavilion to reach the exhibition area. On the left-hand side, you will find the Feedback tab and the Social Media tab to upload the various social media details. On the right-hand side are tabs for downloads to download various agendas, the image gallery and the video gallery. The option for text chat and video call is also available. You can also exchange your business card and know the login status for further interaction. Click on the exhibition to go to the exhibition hall. Click on one of the stalls to reach the exhibition area. Once on a stall, the visitor can view the exhibitor's schedule, documents, product images, and videos. You can interact through audio-video call or text chat and also exchange your business card with the exhibitor. The exhibitors and participating companies can upload documents like company profile, product images and brochures, etc. They can also upload their fascia name, posters and videos. Social media handles can also be uploaded on each booth and pavilions. For any assistance required, dedicated team will be there to assist. Detailed guidelines for uploading information and documents in booth and pavilion will also be shared with each company. Click on Auditorium to reach various seminar halls. Visitors can access the auditorium hall and experience live webinars and pre-recorded sessions. One can find the agenda and Q&A links on the left and right side of the screen. The networking lounge will offer a variety of options that allow you to meet and collaborate with attendees throughout the day. On the left-hand side of the screen, you can find the visitors and buyers list with their business profile and product interest. You can exchange your business card with them. Follow the Maritime India Summit 2021 on social media platforms like Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram. Thank you. Please visit us again.
Thank you. We are privileged and honored to have some of the distinguished stakeholders for signing of MOU with the Director General of Shipping. Now we are starting MOU signing ceremony of the Maritime India Summit 2021 at the Directorate General of Shipping. Before we proceed for the ceremony, I would like to request all the honorable signatories, those who are waiting online for signing of MOU virtually, to keep their video in on continuously. Your audio will be in a mute mode, but when your name will be announced and displayed on the screen, a pop-up message will come to you. You have to accept that message on your screen. While signing MOU, you in your webcam, you have to align in such a way that a clear image of yourself and the MOU should appear. Thank you. Now I Now I request Captain B.B. Sinha, Advisor, Great Eastern Shipping Company Limited, to kindly come upon on dais for signing of MOU. This MOU is for an investment of Rs. 2,500 crore for acquisition of ships under Indian flag.
Congratulations.
Thank you, DG sir. Thank you, Captain Sinha. Now I request Captain Thomas Wilfred Pinto, Chairman and Managing Director, Seven Island Shipping Limited, to kindly come upon stage for signing of MOU. This MOU is for an investment of Rs. 2000 CR for acquisition of ship. Captain Pinto is signing three MOUs with a total investment of Rs. 2000 CR. Investment of Rs. 2000 crore for acquisition of ship for establishing Maritime Institute. Thank you, DG sir. Thank you, Captain Pinto. I now request Shri Pranab Jha, Head Shipping JSW Shipping and Logistic Private Limited, to kindly come up on stage on dais for signing of MOU. Shri Pranab Jha, Head Shipping JSW Shipping and Logistic Private Limited, will be signing 3 MOU with DG Shipping with an investment of rupees 155 crore for acquisition of 1,550 crore for acquisition of ship for registration under Indian flag. The company is also building ship which will run on battery electric power for promotion of green shipping. Thank you, DG sir. Thank you, Jha sir. I now request Captain Anshul Rajwansi, Managing Director, Synergy Maritime Recruitment Services Private Limited, to kindly come on dais for signing of MOU. This MOU is for placement of 20,000 additional seafarer on Indian and foreign flagship in 5 years, involving investment of rupees 3,660 crore. Thank you, DG sir. Thank you, Captain Rajwanshi. I now request Shri Manish Pradhan, Managing Director, Anglo-Eastern Ship Management India Private Limited, to kindly come up on dais for signing of MOU. This MOU is for the placement of 5,000 additional seafarer in next 5 year on Indian and foreign flagships, involving investment of rupees 3,038 crores. Thank you, DG sir. Thank you, Pradhan sir. I now request Captain Prashant S. Rangnekar, CEO, Indian Operation Elegant Marine Service Private Limited, to kindly come up on dais for signing of MOU. This MOU is for placement of 7,500 additional seafarer on Indian and foreign flagships in 5 years, involving investment of rupees 2,994 crore. Thank you, DG sir. I now request Captain M.P. Bhaseen, MD MSC Crewing. He will be signing. Captain Bhaseen, MD, Managing Director of MSC Crewing, will be signing MOU for. He is signing MOU for academic and educational cooperation for skill development of seafarer for cargo and crews. He will be signing another MOU with DG Shipping as a chairman MASA and trustee of Maritime Training and Research Foundation for sponsorship for higher education and to develop academic and educational cooperation to promote quality and skill upgradation of Indian seafarer. Thank you, DG sir. Thank you, Captain Bhaseen. I now request Dr. Rakesh Singh, Director, RMU Charitable Trust, to kindly come up on dais for signing of MOU. DG Shipping is signing MOU with Director, IMU Charitable Trust on establishment of a maritime university. With an investment of approximately 50 crore. Thank you, DG sir. Thank you, Dr. Singh. Now I request Shri Sanjeev S. Vakil, Chief Executive Officer, HIMT Ship Management, to kindly come up on dais for signing of MOU. DG Shipping is signing 4 MOU with Shri Sanjeev Vakil, CEO, HIMT Ship Management. This MOU is for an investment of rupees 30 crore on establishment of international MTI at Dubai or Sri Lanka, MTI at Rajasthan, sponsorship for higher education, ship management agency, and expansion of institutes. Thank you, sir. Now we are moving towards signing of online MOUs. Before we proceed, I would like to repeat and request the same, all the honorable signatories, those who are signing MOU virtually, to keep their video on. You will receive an message, pop-up message, and that you have to accept, whereby your audio video will be on. I request Shri S.K. Mehta, IFS Chairman, Deen Dayal Port Trust. This MOU is for sponsorship of higher education. Next, now I request Shri Sharad Sarangadharan, Executive Director. My apologies. Now I request Vice Chairman, Gujarat Maritime University, to please log in. Gujarat Maritime Board. He will be signing MOU. She will be signing MOU for cooperation and collaboration on academic and skill development, experts and resources in skill development. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Good afternoon, sir.
Welcome to this roadshow.
Yes, sir. Thank you for signing this MOU with the university, sir.
I'm sure this MOU is going to add to the cooperation between Directorate General of Shipping and Gujarat Maritime University, and of course, Gujarat Maritime Board.
So, we think it's a good fortune that we are collaborating with the Director General of Shipping, and that gives the Gujarat Maritime University an opportunity to bring the resources that we have at a national level, collaborating for human resource development and capacity building at a national scale. So we thank you for this opportunity. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request Professor Dr. S. Shanta Kumar, Director, Gujarat National Law University, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is for knowledge cluster. I now request Shri Madhu S. Nair, Chairman and Managing Director, Cochin Shipyard Limited, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. Welcome, sir.
Good afternoon, sir, and happy to do this MOU with Digi Shipping. Again, happy to see that the World Maritime University courses will come to India.
Thank you very much, Madhu Nair Sahab, for entering into this MOU. And I'm sure with support of people like you, this venture would be a grand success.
Thanks a lot, sir.
This MOU is for sponsorship for higher education. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I now request Shri Durgesh Kumar Dubey, Deputy Chairman, Vizag Port, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. Welcome, sir.
Good morning, sir.
I can't see.
So we are sponsoring, sir, one student for higher education offered by World Maritime University at the Indian campus.
I can see Chairman Saab also. Welcome to this roadshow. And thank you very much for entering into this MOU. I am sure with your support, this venture is going to be a grand success. And it will be beneficial to the Indian maritime community, including the commercial sector.
This MOU is for sponsorship for higher education. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
I now request Shri P. Jairaj Kumar, Chairman and Managing Director, Ocean Sparkle Limited, to kindly log in for signing of MOU.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Shri P. Jairaj Kumar, Chairman and Managing Director, Ocean Sparkle Limited, will be signing two MOU with DG Shipping. MOU is on shipbuilding and sponsorship for higher education, involving investment of rupees 125 crore.
Please mention that this is shipbuilding in India.
Good afternoon, sir, and thank you for giving us this opportunity. Our company Ocean Sparkle wishes to construct three tugboats at reputed Indian shipyards to support the directives of the Government of India in furtherance of the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. The total capex investment is 125 crores and it will give employment for approximately 75 people with an economic impact of 150 crores in 5 years. Thank you for giving us this opportunity, sir.
Thank you, sir. I now request Mr. Shivaswamy Iyer Ramakrishnan, Chairman, Shreyas Shipping and Logistics, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. Shreyas Shipping and Logistics is signing five MOUs with DG Shipping. These MOUs will be on shipbuilding in India, ship repair, and container manufacturing. This will be for an investment of rupees 675 crore. Thank you, sir. I now request Dr. Sujata Nayak, Director and Chairperson, Tulani Group, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. Dr. Nayak will be signing five MOUs with DG Shipping. These five MOUs are on ship acquisition, expansion in training capacity and research and development, involving an investment of ₹171 crore. Dr. Sujata Naik also signing MOU on behalf of Maritime Training Trust for sponsorship on higher education.
Very good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon and welcome to this roadshow.
Thank you, sir. Happy to be signing these MOUs with you all. I just want to again state what we are doing. We're, you know, hoping to put money into ship acquisitions, almost greater than 400 crores in the 5 years, with the likely economic impact of about 346 crores. We are also looking to do increase in our Maritime Institute capacity. Today we have a capacity per year of 440 students annual intake. We will increase that by 40 so that we could graduate about 480 students per year from TMI. We hope to achieve that soon. We also would like to open a research and development consultancy center, which would probably have an investment over almost 20 crores in the 5 years. We are also looking to sponsor students to the WMU. And even though I have not actually put a paper in on this or a document in, we definitely are in line to open a maritime university. So I have not already put the paper in, so I'm not going to quote an amount, but that is definitely in the pipeline too. So happy to be signing these documents and happy to be signing for MTT for supporting two students to WMU. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. And we look forward to continued engagement, both for ship ownership, ship registration, maritime training, research in maritime sector and employment from Tolani Group. Thank you very much.
Absolutely. Always there for. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank
Mr. Shivaswamy Iyer Ramakrishnan, Chairman Shreyas Shipping and Logistics, has now joined us. Sir, can you hear us? Please unmute him.
Seven, seven. Serial number 7. We are requesting you to go back to serial number 7. He could not join. He wants to join. He has called up to speak at this session. So please unmute him. Then we will resume further.
Sir,
hello. Hello. Can you hear me, sir?
Who is there? He may have signed with some other names. I push up again. Who is the one?
We can continue. We can log in later for him.
So continue with
I now request Mr. K.P. Unnikrishnan, Director, Seema Marine India Private Limited, to kindly log in for signing of MOU.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity to signing an MOU with the DG Shipping and promoting Indian shipping under your leadership.
Good afternoon, sir. This MOU is for an investment of ₹177 crore for acquisition of ships for registration under Indian flag.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I request Mr. Sivaswamy Iyer, sir, to kindly log in.
Yeah.
Welcome, sir. Good afternoon.
Yeah. Thank you very much. There was some confusion on the technology aspect. I'm very happy and pleased to have signed the MOU. As Shreyas and as Transworld Group, we are very keen and looking forward to ordering ships in the Indian shipyards. And we are also looking at acquiring ships to run on the Indian coast. In addition to that, we are very pleased to learn about the World Maritime University that's being opened. And as an organization, we are very, very pleased to also sponsor students for this particular aspect. And we are looking forward to cooperating and working very hard in building India into a wonderful maritime nation. Thank you very much, sir, for giving us an opportunity.
Thank you very much. And we acknowledge the great contribution that Shreyas has made in coastal shipping, especially containerized cargo movement on Indian coast. And we hope for continued cooperation between the two organizations. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I now request Shri Suresh Bhai Parekh, Director Polestar Maritime, to kindly log in for signing of MOU with DG sir.
Vikram.
This MOU is on shipbuilding in India, which involves an investment of rupees 35 crore.
Has he joined? Okay, we can move to the next one then.
Thank you, sir. Now moving to the next MOU, I now request Dr. Jayant Kumar, Head of Human Resource, Ports and Logistics, Adani Port Special Economic Zone Limited, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is on sponsorship for higher education. Good afternoon and welcome, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. Very happy to be part of this initiative, sponsoring for Indian campus of World Maritime University, and we'll keep partnering with DG Shipping and in future as well. Thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you. Sir. Thank you for this generous offer.
Thank you, sir.
I now request Shri Rajiv Agarwal, Managing Director, SR Ports Limited, to kindly log in for signing of MOU with DG Shipping.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes. Good afternoon. Welcome and good afternoon, sir.
My name is Captain Deepak and I'm representing Mr. Agarwal. It is an absolute pleasure and an honor to be signing this MOU. Thank you very much and we look forward to be associated with this for a long, long time.
Thank you very much and thanks for this initiative.
The pleasure is all ours, sir. Thank you. Proud.
I now request Shri Prabhat Kumar Jha, CEO and Group Managing Director, MSC Ship Management Limited, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is on employment to 5,000 seafarers in next 5 years. Good afternoon and welcome, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much. And we are privileged to sign this MOU with the DG Shipping. As the market knows that India is one of the strong pillars for MSC growth. And MSC has been investing a lot in the fleet renewal program and expanding its fleet. And this naturally requires more seafarers to operate the ships. And Indian seafarers by their quality are known worldwide, and MSC has put its full trust in increasing the Indian seafarers in the coming future. And besides this number that we will increase, we are also recruiting the people for the cruises and also the ro-pax ships. And we are training about 500 cadets every year from the India. And we will continue with our focus on India and growing the Indian seafarers and upgrading their skills in the future. We are very proud to join this event. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, MSC, for reposing your faith in Indian training and Indian seafarers. And we hope to remain in cooperation so that the quality of Indian seafarers continue to remain high and we remain better than others in the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I now request Shri Digvijay Pratap Singh, Director, Main Mast Merchants Private Limited, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This
Thank you,
MOU,
sir, for inviting us.
He is signing three MOUs. The MOUs on creation of ship repair facility in India and placement of 500 seafarers, of which mostly on cruise vessels, involving an investment of rupees 100 crores.
Thank you, sir, for inviting us. And it is a pleasure to announce that we have yesterday we have signed one MOU to Made in India to Jacobabad. Shortly, we will be laying the key link and we will be inviting Ministry of Shipping and DG Shipping, sir, also.
Thank you very much for showing interest in Make in India initiative of the Honorable Prime Minister and for continued support in employment of Indian seafarers, both on cruise and merchant ships. Thank you, sir.
I now request Shri Suraj J. Dalani, CMD, Konkan Maritime Cluster, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. Good afternoon, sir. This MOU is supporting dry dock facility in India involving an investment of rupees 154 crore.
Very good afternoon to Shri Dr. Amita Kumar, sir. And I would really want to thank you, take this opportunity for the vision of India's first maritime cluster to be established in Goa. Goa has pioneered this development of the MSME shipyards under the able leadership of Honorable Chief Minister Dr. Pramod Sawant. Special thanks to the Directorate General Shipping Office to Shri Captain Jay Kumar sir, Bodhraj sir, and Shri Captain Mohit Bail for their continual support and guidance, without which the MSME shipyards and shipbuildings in Goa would not be able to come to this point. Konkan Maritime Cluster is a conglomerate of more than 49 MSME shipyards in Goa, and we have unified to empower the MSME shipbuilding industry in Goa so that we can serve the west coast of India. And with the set of the floating dry dock, there will be a tremendous employment opportunity, and also we'll get to serve the shipping community in the west coast of India, where the floating dry dock facility is the need of the hour. Dr. Amitabh Kumar, sir, once again, thank you so much for showing this confidence in us, and we will make you proud, sir.
Thank you very much for coming forward for this MOU. It will again add to the Prime Minister's initiative of Make in India, and also add to the strength of Konkan Maritime Cluster. We are proud to be associated with you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. I now request Captain Sudhansh Kumar Gupta, Joint President, Ports and Shipping, Ambuja Cements Limited. He will be signing two MOUs with shipping. These MOUs will be on shipbuilding vessel in India and creating facility for biodiesel with an investment of Rs. 1.8 crore. Good afternoon and welcome, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much for giving us permission and support to carry out the sea trials for using biodiesel on our ships. Sir, Ambuja Cements will be the first company to start using biodiesel on ships after successful sea trials. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ambuja Cement. This is one of the most important MOUs that we are signing along with the one with JSW to promote environment-friendly shipping in our coast. And I hope this initiative will ultimately grow into a full-fledged fleet for Indian ships, which are in compliance with IMO 2030 guideline or 2050 guideline, and maybe be the first to achieve that target. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I now request Mr. Marshall Verma, Managing Director, Rohi Global Services Private Limited, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is on employment of 1400 additional seafarers in next 5 years. The investment is of rupees 67 crore.
Good afternoon, sir. Thank you.
Welcome and good afternoon, sir.
Fortunately to be a part of this initiative. And we're very happy to sign this agreement with you. Today is actually a very important day for us as well, because as we sign this agreement, we have got two new under our management, and we'll be sending people on these ships in the next 1 month, starting off from April onwards. And besides that, we have also signed the agreement of 12 cargo ships. So that brings us into the place where we will be able to offer a lot of opportunities to Indian seafarers. And thank you for being supportive of this initiative.
Thank you very much, and continue to do well so that more and more Indian seafarers are employed on your managed vessels.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your support.
Thank you, sir. I now request Mr. Shahzad M. Malik, Helm Institute of Maritime Studies, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. Good afternoon, sir. This MOU is on Maritime Training Institute, involving investment of rupees 30 crore.
Good afternoon to you, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for giving us an opportunity to sign an MOU with you, with DG Shipping. My all good wishes to you, sir, for the success of this event, sir. And we'll be continually contributing from our side, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
So I'll be signing two MOU, sir. One for dredging in Ahmedabad, and the other maritime training skill development in Jharkhand, sir.
Very good.
One is of 5 crore rupees, sir, and the other is of 30 crore rupees, sir.
Good. Great.
Thank you so much, sir.
I now request Mr. S. I. Nathan, Chairman CMC Group of Institutes to kindly log in for signing of MOU with DG, sir.
Very good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon. Chairman of CMC Group of Institutions. CMC Group of Institutions presently conducting PC courses at Coimbatore in the name of Coimbatore Marine College and in Mangalore, Mangalore Marine College and Technology. And that is the only and first institution in the entire state of Karnataka. CMC Maritime Academy Chennai conducting various OC courses. And this year we are commencing Sunav Maritime Academy in collaboration with the Sunav Shipping Company, who is having about a 42 ship manning at Chennai. And this MOU we are signing with the DGS for opening up our next maritime institution at Kochi. I sincerely thank our DG sir for giving us this opportunity. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. I now request Captain R. Anand, Trustee and Principal, HIMT College, Tidal Park, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is on establishment of Maritime Training Institute in Gujarat, involving an investment of rupees 9 crores. Welcome and good afternoon, Captain Anand.
Good afternoon, sir, and thank you very much for giving us this opportunity. We will be establishing our training institute at Gujarat, where we expect to train about 3,000 seafarers annually. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. I now request Captain Sanjay Parashar, Managing Director, VR Maritime Private Limited, to kindly log in for signing of MOU with DG, sir. This MOU is for establishment of Maritime Training Institute in Himachal Pradesh and employment to Indian seafarer. This MOU is for also for an investment of rupees 5.5 crore. Good afternoon and welcome, sir.
नमस्कार सर, धन्यवाद. मैं चित्तपुरनी से हिमाचल प्रदेश से बोल रहा हूँ, अपने कार्यालय से. सर, सर्वप्रथम ये हमारे लिए नया तजुर्बा है एंड यू नो पूरी इंडस्ट्री को साथ में देख के बड़ा अच्छा लग रहा है. करोड़ों की इन्वेस्टमेंट आ रही है तो हिमाचल प्रदेश में करीब 8,000 सीकरर्स हैं. हमारा एक प्रयास है कि पोस्ट सी कोर्सेज यहाँ पर हों और आसपास का जो क्षेत्र है, आसपास के जो राज्य हैं, उसको भी इसे लाभ मिले. तो करीब 8,000 सीकरर्स जो हिमाचली हैं, उसमें हमारा प्रयास रहेगा कि कम से कम 2,500 सीकरर्स के जो पोस्ट सी कोर्सेज हैं वो यहाँ से हों. आने वाले समय में सर, ये हमने जो एमओयू आपके साथ साइन किया है सर, वेरी हैप्पी फ्रॉम अ स्मॉल विलेज इन हिमाचल प्रदेश एंड थैंक यू सो मच सर. जय हिंद, जय नाविक.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
आई नाउ रिक्वेस्ट कैप्टन के एन देबू, प्रिंसिपल, एंग्लो ईस्टर्न मैरिटाइम ट्रेनिंग सेंटर, टू काइंडली लॉग इन फॉर साइनिंग एमओयू. This MOU is for academic and educational cooperation and for skill upgradation of seafarer. Good afternoon and welcome, Captain Debu.
Good afternoon, sir. Anglo-Eastern Maritime Training Center and Anglo-Eastern Maritime Academy are pleased to enter into an MOU with DG Shipping for the improvement of the quality of Indian seafarers to enable them to serve on specialized ships belonging to the world fleet. As you know, Anglo-Eastern has been a pioneer in maritime training, and it was established in 94. It's equipped with the latest of simulators, shipboard equipment, automation labs, workshop, and also various OEM courses. So the purpose of our MOU is to develop academic and educational cooperation to promote skill upgradation of Indian seafarers so that they are ready and fit for purpose on specialized modern day ships. This would definitely increase the marketability of Indian seafarers in the world marine manpower supply. So we are very happy to sign this MOU with DG Shipping. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Captain Debu.
Thank you, sir. I now request Dr. Vaidya Subramaniam, Managing Trustee, HIMT College, Research and Simulator Center of Excellence to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is for establishment of Research and Simulator Center of Excellence at HIMT College, Gujarat.
Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much for giving opportunity to sign this MOU with Data General of Shipping. And we have plan of expansion of HMT College Tidal Park by investing in world-class infrastructure in adjoining land of existing DG-approved MDI. Once again, I thank you very much for giving opportunity to sign this MOU. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I now request Sri V.R. Venkateshan, Director, Academic HIMT, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is for establishment of Maritime Training Institute in Rajasthan, involving an investment of five crore. Investment of rupees 5 crore.
Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much for this opportunity to sign this MOU. We at HIMT look forward to taking the challenge of taking maritime opportunities to the deserts of Rajasthan. We will put in our best efforts to increase the number of Indian seafarers. This program of ours is expected to benefit about 5,000 seafarers per year. Thank you very much once again for this opportunity.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I now request Mr. Keerthan S., Business Development Manager, HIMT, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is for establishment of a skill-based research center and with an investment of rupees 5 crore.
Good afternoon, sir. It's an absolute honor to be signing this MOU with the Director General of Shipping. This skill-based research center would be carrying out research, trying to identify gaps of present and the future of autonomous vessels by setting up a shore-based center. And this is amongst the other MOUs which we have signed, including the MOU of sponsoring candidates to WMU. I was a part of WMU and I would like to be a part of the alma mater. So that is also one of the MOUs which we would be sponsoring for. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I now request Captain Arun Yagnik, Principal Marina Academy of Maritime Research Center and Charitable Trust, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is for establishment of training center in the field of dredging.
Good afternoon, sir. This is the Captain Arun Yagnik from Marina Academy. With regard to advancement and further knowledge of dredging technology, my owner, Mr. Shajad Malik, has already signed an MOU with the DG Shipping. And I want to make more modernization in the dredging technology in India, so that we become self-sufficient and won't have to invite any foreign companies for doing dredging with us. For us, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. It is a very important subject, and I hope that your training academy is a big success. Gujarat is also a very good state to have this academy. With a lot of ports and maritime activities happening there, both at the central level and at the state level. And I hope it makes India self-sufficient in dredging in days to come.
Thank you, sir. I now request Sri S.K. Bhavnani, Chairman FOSMA, to kindly log in for signing of MOU. This MOU is for sponsorship of our higher education. Good afternoon and welcome, sir.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon to you.
We would thank the Director General of Shipping for giving FOSMA the opportunity to be a part of the series of the initiatives being taken for the development of the Indian maritime community. It is indeed an honor for all of us at FOSMA to be signing this MOU, which will certainly enhance the levels of maritime education and training and will enable India to continue to be a global leader in all maritime domains. We thank you, sir, for all the various initiatives taken to promote Indian shipping at all times, which will certainly become a benchmark for all maritime countries to emulate if it has not already been so. Once again, sir, thank you very much, and we look forward to India continuing to be at the top at all times to come. Thank you once again. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now we are moving towards the last MOU. Now I request Shri Abdul Ghani Sarang, General Secretary, come Treasurer, National Union for Seafarers of India, NUSSI, to kindly come up on dais for signing of MOU. This MOU is for sponsorship on higher education.
Thank you.
There is one announcement, that is, we have received one more MOU from Carnival Cruise. Though he is not joining, neither physically nor online, but we have received MOU from Carnival Cruise.
Sir, it is a pleasure to associate ourselves with this activity. Aksar corporate social responsibility ke baare mein aksar sunte CSR. As a trade union, it is a pleasure to do USR, Union Social Responsibility, and we are very happy in doing that. Thank you so much, and we have a very proactive Maritime Administration and definitely the Ministry of Shipping also. Aur hame badi khushi ho rahi to associate ourselves in this activity for the overall development. Thank you so much. To hum USR karte ye yaad rakhna. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. I now request Shri Prasad Hariharan from Carnival Cruise to kindly log in for signing of MOU.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Mr. Prasad Hariharan. Can you explain a little bit about your MOU?
Yes, the MOUs that you have, it's one for setting up a training academy dedicated for cruise staff, and the other is for continuing to increase the employment of Indian seafarers on board our cruise ships. This is part of the entire Carnival group, represented by 9 international brands.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hariharan, for entering into this MOU. The two MOUs, one for setting up an academy and training Indians to join cruise ships, and also ensuring that each and every one who passes from this training institute gets recruited with the Carnival Group. and the other for engaging Indians in your group of fleet. We welcome you here, and we hope that this cooperation between the two organizations continue and more Indians get employed with the Carnival Group. Thank you.
Most definitely, sir. Thank you very much for inviting us to be part of this roadshow. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now I request DG sir to address all the esteemed guests physically present at the Directorate General of Shipping and those who have joined online. May I request DG sir to kindly address the guests.
Organizing this Maritime India Summit 2021 is a vision of our minister, Mr. Mansukh Mandavia, who has been very proactive in development of shipping as well as port sector in India. The Honorable Prime Minister is the key motivator for development of maritime activities in India. He has done so in Gujarat as Chief Minister, and he continues to show interest in maritime activities even after taking over the role of the Prime Minister. And despite his busy schedule, he spares time for this industry and keeps himself abreast with the growth in this sector. It is not very often that we display the strength and importance of the shipping industry to the world, be it the importance that ship registry in India brings, ship construction in India, management of ships in India or by Indian companies or their affiliates, the role of training in Indian maritime sector, and of course, the role that Indian seafarers play as ambassadors of the country in the maritime world. The gamut of MOUs that we have signed today shows the strength of India in ship ownership, in ship manufacturing, in maritime training, knowledge, the cluster of knowledge that is required, and the commitment of the Indian ship owners to promote shipbuilding, manufacturing, and other allied industries in India. The cumulative figure of MOUs signed today exceeds 20,000 crore. And I am very sure in my mind that this is just the tip of the iceberg that we see in Indian maritime industry as its potential. As we move forward, as we implement these MOUs in a year or so, we will see a spurt in the growth of maritime industry. We have the resource, we have the knowledge, we have the manpower, and we have the will to take India to the next stage in the maritime sector. And with all of us together, everyone who has signed the MOU and those who are still thinking about it or plan to do that in future, would make India the ship ownership hub, the ship manufacturing hub, maritime cluster hub, knowledge hub, and of course, a hub for employment of seafarers. I wish all of you the very best. I also implore all of you to participate in this summit, register yourself for the summit, and make sure that you gain from the galaxy of speakers that have been lined up for the plenary sessions and for breakout sessions in the 3-day summit. The third day of the summit, while the first day will have the 2 sessions that relate to the Directorate General directly, the other sessions also would be of interest to you or related to you, whether it is on coastal shipping or on skill development or on environment and environment protection, port development. These are the areas that would be of interest to us, both as ship owners, regulators, seafarers, or those having any kind of interest in Indian maritime sector. The last day of the session is on Chabar and the plans that India have for growth and expansion of Chabar. It will also throw a lot of business opportunities and employment opportunities for Indians once Chabar is fully operationalized. And I hope all of us will join and share our views on the Chabar session on the third day. I wish the summit organizers the very best. It is one of the best organized summits on a virtual platform. And the more we participate in the summit, it will not only make the summit a success, it will also make us richer in terms of knowledge, in terms of information, and in terms of participation with the best in the globe. Thank you very much, and I look forward to continued cooperation. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for your keynote address on Maritime India Summit 2021. Now we are moving to the last but not the least part of the function. I request Dr. Pandurang Rao, DDG Training, to kindly come up on stage, on dais, to give vote of thanks.
Very good afternoon to all. It is indeed a great pleasure to have this august gathering here, assembled to witness a very special function of roadshow and MOU signing ahead of Maritime India Summit 2021. On behalf of the Directorate General of Shipping, I would like to wholeheartedly express my deepest gratitude and profound gratefulness towards the distinguished delegates from the maritime world for your overwhelming response and enthusiasm in signing around 60 MOUs covering 20,000 crore rupees of investment with DG Shipping in various fields related to maritime sector. We are deeply honored to have you all here in spite of all the constraints of current pandemic. We are also thanking to those who have joined with us. I think more than 400 participants have joined online also. I would like to wholeheartedly express my profound thanks to Sri Amitabh Kumarji, Director General of Shipping and Additional Secretary to Government of India. Sir, we are sure that with your insightful thinking and futuristic vision will always inspire us and make a big success in various new ventures. Thank you very much, sir. I also thank Sri Kumar Sanjay Bariyar Saab, Additional DG Shipping, for giving the insight of the summit and giving the detailed information of the summit. I would like to profusely thank to all those guests who have joined with us seafarers, their unions, for joining us and making this event more successful. Last but not the least, it would not have been possible to hold such a mega event, although it is appearing small here, but if it would have been in a big auditorium, it would have been a very grand, successful event. Without the sincere efforts and unflinching commitment of the officers of DGCPing, staff, technical experts, the event management personnel, I thank all of you. I again request all the participants to make their all-round efforts to get their seafarers, their friends registered on the online link of www.maritimeindiasummit.in and make this summit as a most mega successful event in the world. I kindly request all of you to join with us for the snacks in the cafeteria in the adjoining room. Thank you very much, sir. I'm very sorry. I thank the media. Press and media who have joined with us. And I'm very hopeful that they will cover this event and the coming mega event of Maritime India Summit 21, so that it will give the benefits to all the citizens of India and all the persons involved in maritime sector in the world. Thank you very much. You may please join with us for the snacks in the adjoining room.
Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye for now.